Good afternoon. Would you please stand? Sorry, I tried to get to you earlier. I'm pleased to declare the 2013 commencement exercises for Quinnipiac University's School of Communications, School of Health Sciences, and School of Nursing officially open. The invocation will be delivered by Shamshad Sheikh, Muslim chaplain.
Let us pray. O God of mercy, love, and compassion, it is with great joy we come together today to honor accomplishment of our graduating class of 2013. Thank you, God, for this day and for this gathering. We thank you for the gift and talent that you have given to our seniors, and we thank you that we had the chance to know them, to love them, to teach them, and to learn from them. Realizing they will leave us and go on to do great adventure, so we ask your blessing on this event. Allow us to laugh, cry, and remember all the joy and wisdom that has been brought to this campus. Recognizing your hand in all good things, we pray, O Lord, that each graduate will be inspired by the wonder of life and touched by the goodness of people as they contribute to making our world a better place. May the light of wisdom give illumination to their path as they take the next step in their life's journey. May they be blessed with creativity to imagine the unimaginable, courage to face unthinkable, conviction to live with integrity, and compassion for the suffering of in our world. May they be guided by the path of love, joy, peace, kindness, and help them to become a vibrant example of shalom, salam, shanti, and peace. Amen.
Please be seated. I'd like to acknowledge our platform party, which includes trustees, university administrators, university clergy, and deans. It is now my honor to present Dr. John L. Leahy, president of Quinnipiac University, who will bring you greetings on behalf of the university community.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to all of you on this joyous occasion. To our graduates, the class of 2013, I want to add a special welcome and my heartiest congratulations to each and every one of you. During your years at Quinnipiac, you have made all of us very proud, and we have good reason to believe that in the years ahead, you'll become leaders in your professions and role models within your families and communities. The class of 2013 is without question one of the very best in Quinnipiac's history, and certainly one of my favorites. 17 of today's graduates were recently inducted into the prestigious Who's Who among students in American colleges and universities. This class has also achieved the highest level ever of cum laude, magna cum laude, and summa cum laude academic honors. A record number of you are going on to pursue graduate degrees in various fields of study, including dental, law, and medical school. And I'm pleased to report that three Quinnipiac graduates, including one of today's graduates, Timothy O'Rourke, who's sitting out there today, has been admitted into the inaugural class of the new Frank H. Netter School of Medicine here at Quinnipiac University. Class of 2013, as you look back on all of your accomplishments, I am sure you'll agree with me that you would not be graduating today if it were not for the help and support of two very important groups, the faculty at Quinnipiac and your families. Class of 2013, please rise and express your appreciation to the faculty in front of you and your parents and families behind you. Class of 2013, you have certainly left your mark on Quinnipiac University, and for that we thank you. And I predict you will leave an even greater mark on the world that awaits you. Again, my congratulations and best wishes to each and every one of you.
I now call forward Josh Elliott, Richard Hanley, and President Leahy for the conferral of the honorary degree.
Josh Elliott, as news anchor for ABC's Good Morning America, you keep us up to date with the major stories breaking each day. You contribute in no small part to the chemistry that has garnered GMA an average daily audience of 5.3 million, making GMA the number one morning news program. Often, you travel from the anchor's desk to the scene of the action to report live. Recent stories you have covered include the Sandy Hook shootings, the aftermath of Hurricane Sandy, and the election of Pope Francis in Rome. You had an exclusive interview with former Penn State President Graham Spanier in the wake of the Jerry Sandusky scandal. Switching seamlessly from news to sports and entertainment, you have led GMA's coverage of the Super Bowl for the past 3 years and co-hosted Emmy's Red Carpet Live. You serve as a role model for the contemporary journalist who is committed to the principles and practices of journalism while reporting on many platforms. Before Good Morning America, you made your mark on ESPN's SportsCenter after working as a guest contributor to several ESPN programs, including Cold Pizza. For your writing and reporting contributions to the MSG program, Angles, you were awarded a New York Emmy in 2005. In recognition of your ability to relate to an audience on cable, network, digital, and social media, and your penchant for telling a story well, Quinnipiac University is pleased to confer upon you the honorary degree of Doctor of Humane Letters this 19th of May, 2013.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, Josh.
It's my privilege to introduce Quinnipiac University's newest alumnus, Josh Elliott, to give the commencement address.
I am now one of you. It feels great. I want to thank President Dr. John Leahy, Senior Vice President Dr. Mark Thompson, Dean Lee Camlett, Dean Ed O'Connor, Dean Gene Lang, and Professor Rich Hanley. I also want to make a nod very quickly to my former life there at Sports Illustrated and ESPN, and so salute the mighty men's hockey Bobcats. It was the first time I'd had a rooting interest in the Frozen Four, and it was a remarkable ride. It is an honor to be asked to speak to you on a day that must have felt so far off for so very long. I, too, remember the haze of my graduation day, for which the night before my graduation day was largely responsible. For almost two decades, of course, you have trudged to this point, summer's beginning, knowing that the next school year would be here soon enough. But now, for a great many of you, summer will have a new name, life. You've taken your last final, maybe given your last excuse, procrastinated the last time as you inhaled the internet's innards for hours at a time, learning everything about everything else other than that which you should have been doing. Yes, for many of you, this is the last pseudo-requirement of your educational careers, which also means that the vast majority of you have probably already stopped listening. So that's understandable, except for those of you in, like, the front row. I'm going to be looking at you. But at least for those of you in the School of Communications, feel free, work the iPhones, work the tablets, because today, at long last, you are putting your degrees to use. You are communicating, and that's terrific. I did so myself today. I tweeted, congratulations to all of you, the esteemed graduates of the great Quinnipiac University, and it is a remarkable thing to have done, to have traversed two decades of organized education that actually began for you before Google and Facebook even existed. Two places where homework now goes to die. When you began in preschool and kindergarten, in fact, your media were probably leaned towards Play-Doh and Crayolas. The idea of the then boxy and clunky personal computer as a student necessity, no way. When you were beginning those careers, we were all still using typewriters without irony. Now, technology isn't just fast and efficient and seemingly all-powerful. It's also cotton candy light and flat as a board. Whether it's the TVs that hang on our walls or the iPads that make you wonder how we ever survived with those ancient first-generation iPhones while we were out there painting caves and hunting woolly mammoth. I think back to the days when we didn't begin spelling the word book with E hyphen. And when libraries were, in fact, buildings and not computer files. And when the University of Phoenix would have actually been in the city of Phoenix. And I am more amazed at your accomplishments. For the ability to deliver knowledge quicker and more thoroughly, as it grew, so did the expectation that all of you could then consume more of it. So today, as you finally push yourself away from the table full of facts and figures and foreign languages, I want you to know, truly, what a staggering achievement it is to have accomplished. And in doing so, I'd also like to acknowledge those who truly drew the collective short straw today. I speak, of course, of the wonderful graduates of the schools of health sciences and nursing. You must now feign interest in a guy who struggles to apply a Hello Kitty Band-Aid. You're looking at me thinking, boy, these 4 years were really worth it. Thanks for that. But believe me, it is true when they say that it takes a village. For as every village needs a medical professional, that village needs you because there is also a village idiot. So we are in dire need of you. And so I can only apologize for my presence today and ask that you get out there and help save lives. You do it. I want you to know, too, that when you give me that next shot, I don't totally hate you. It wears off by the time I'm done with my lollipop, so that's important. But to effectively treat fragile folks such as myself, you will have to rely not just on your years of education and training, but also your intuition and your sense of context and situation. And it is in that nexus that all of you, as you leave today and doff these ill-fitting robes, and nurse the hangovers, and you know who I'm talking about. It's how you're all joined as one, because there is one thing that all of the three schools represented here today have done together in choosing the seemingly dissimilar professional paths that you are about to walk. You have all decided to go into the business of being right all the time. Whether you're going to work every day in a TV newsroom or a research lab, a PR department or a hospital ward, you will be bound by the need to not ever be wrong ever. And as I promise that that's as scary as this little speech is going to get today, it's also a statement derived from fear. And not just because I didn't want to be someone that made you look back and say, most important day of my life and he ruined everything. And not just because I feared boring you to tears and wondering how you were ever going to get those 15 minutes of your life back. But also it was a terror that I would not adequately express to you this idea that when you finally start a life of paychecks and 401ks and casual Fridays, you've all chosen to do so in professions where you are either right or you are unemployed or worse. Those of you who've chosen to exist in communications, you have made a brave choice. You enter a limitless world now with an insatiable need for information. And as either the sentinels or the seekers of that information, you will need fortitude, for as media proliferates, the business models for capitalizing it collapse in on themselves. Traditional media increasingly portrayed as bogged dinosaurs on the way to becoming fossil fuel, even as content and the access to it multiplies exponentially, and that access, instantaneous and unchecked, just made your jobs far more interesting and far more difficult. Social media have connected our lives as we live them right now, more dynamically and more completely than ever before. A world of smartphones and Twitter can become so many vast things so quickly. In a matter of moments, we can have a global candlelight vigil. We can have a world sports bar or a universal jury of our peers. That is now where millions and millions go to mourn together, to celebrate together. Congressional hearings, presidential press conferences, papal elections are parsed, are conducted there. And as we now know, a world watches our tiny screens now as a city sits under lockdown during the hunt for evil as twilight falls on Watertown, Massachusetts, all captured in 140 character bursts. Kids even younger than you now experience Twitter as your parents, and yes, as I once did, a newspaper. With unfathomable technology behind it, Twitter is inarguably the most nimble purveyor of information the world has ever known. When was the last time, truly, that you learned something new from a newspaper or, God forbid, given my line of work, a television show? But then think about it. When was the last time you learned something new from your Twitter feed? Probably for most of you about 10 seconds ago, because here I am blathering up there and you're looking at your smartphones. But it is no less true. But that is also where the new world evils lurk, where information and technology are employed inappropriately, or really when those doing so place a premium on the wrong things. It is then that this same media becomes anti-social, or worse, very dangerous. For news, incomplete or unverified or best guessed at isn't news at all. It is rumor. It is innuendo. It is a big, fat lie. Those are the silent killers of the information age. You can delete a tweet, but you can't really. You cannot erase the exchange of information. You wipe away the fingerprints, sure, but that doesn't mean you didn't commit the crime. So remember, the access to information is only as good as the information itself. And moreover, I am struck dumb by the courage and conviction of a choice others of you here today have made to literally hold life in your hands. It is a truly remarkable one, largely because, again, you are choosing a life now where being wrong isn't an option. I mean, we in the journalism game, we assuage ourselves by saying, hey, at least it's not brain surgery. But for some of you, wow, you know, it might be. And that's no small choice. That's no minor responsibility. So I urge you then, regardless of your affiliation with the information communicated, no matter where you are then on that chain of exchange, whether it's statistics from the ball field or a lab, a politician's quote or a proper daily dosage, please, please be right. It will be forever, first and last, the only thing that matters. And maybe the one thing upon which you all agree when you all come back here 20 years from now for your reunion and all hazily recall how lousy that graduation day speech was. And so I come bearing a gift for all of you today, albeit one that you cannot exchange for something you really wanted. It's actually more of an invitation, one offered after I thought these last months, in relative terror, I might add, about what on earth I might offer you in a one-size-fits-all way before you collectively scatter and make this world a better place on this day when symbolically everything is possible. I offer you a simple, and as I've come to learn, a wonderful opportunity, namely the chance to treat yourselves, whether for a year or two, or maybe this last summer, or a couple of weeks, or just these next few hours, the chance to treat yourselves to a mistake. You have earned it. If you are sitting here today wondering if you have the tassel on the right side or the left side, you've earned it. The chance to take a road less traveled for good reason. I want you to face even one questionable decision and maybe get it wrong and to enjoy it and keep it clean, all right? Keep it legal and keep it safe. But make one choice that others question in your life and enjoy it. You are all hurtling at warp speed toward career paths of absolute certainty. So please, take a quick day trip to the land of perhaps. Just take a quick little side visit to the world of why not. Lord knows I did, because when I was you, fresh out of college, I knew for sure what was coming next. I was going to run a movie studio in Los Angeles. I was going to dominate Hollywood, and I was going to make all the movies that you all now illegally download. And I was going to stay in my hometown because it's what I knew. Sure, I'd written for the school paper a bit. I'd freelanced in the journalism game a bit, but that was, I thought then, just a way to pass the time. And I was on my way. I was in LA. I was doing it when a dear friend of mine entered the Peace Corps in Slovakia. After about a year, he had actually started writing these increasingly despondent letters about this Eastern European backwater he was stuck in. And so I thought, you know what? I better go visit him. I'd better just remind him that he'll be back like me in LA soon enough. And so I took a leave from my job. I convinced a friend of mine to quit his, and off we went. 3 weeks, 3 weeks, and we'd be back soon enough. Or so I thought. Until the plane landed, and we began making a spellbinding trek to the Slovakian-Hungarian border, where we found that our friend had just been looking for a little sympathy, because in fact, he was living a remarkable, wonderful life in a wonderland, a life that I never before had conceived. And suddenly those 3 weeks became 2 months with him there. And suddenly I was out of a job that couldn't wait. And still, as we finally bid farewell to him, we did not return. We decided we'd keep going the other way. And as our debts grew, and our parents screamed at us over those long-distance phone calls to get home and hurry up and grow up. Well, I saw the world's wonders, the Parthenon and the Louvre and the pyramids, Vatican City and the old city of Jerusalem, the Roman ruins of North Africa and the cave dwellings of the ancient Turks, and I knew my life was changing. Because I was also seeing the slums of Cairo. Poverty unlike anything I had ever witnessed. And the happiness of the Bedouin tribes dotted along the Gulf of Aqaba, who had nothing and remain to this day the happiest people I have ever known. And as more months passed, as we heard the pleas from home to stop making the biggest mistake of our young lives, I was living in the Sinai Mountains, falling asleep under a sky ablaze with more stars than I'd ever seen, poorer than I'd ever been, and yet, finally, home. And when I finally landed at LAX, months and months and months later, penniless and wayward, I had only one thing to show for the biggest mistake I'd ever made in my whole life: a reason to live. For under those stars and in those slums and standing atop the mountains that overlooked the cradle of Western civilization, I had learned how wonderfully small I really was, how insignificant my successes and failures were, and how many stories there were to tell of the billions with whom we shared this world. My reasons to live. And yeah, I returned to LA. I tried the Hollywood game, but I found very quickly that I didn't want to play it. And one move to New York City, and more than a decade as a professional journalist later, including my last two living in a sort of living heaven at ABC News, that trip remains the best mistake I ever made. It was also something I thought about a month ago when I had to return to Vatican City, as you just heard, this time for work. A few weeks prior, the Pope had retired, something that hadn't happened in almost 600 years. 600 years. when my professional ancestors would have killed for a typewriter. I was there to see the final days of a worldwide momentum as hundreds of thousands of people poured into the city of Rome, come to see history. And I was there on a rainy day, not unlike this one, when so many of those thousands packed every spare molecule surrounding St. Peter's. There, when that smoke poured forth from the Sistine Chapel, which, despite all you're prepared for, I just want you to know, you still don't know if it's black or white. You have to wait, because it's smoke, people. And smoke, it turns out, is black and white. And I was there when, however impossibly, a Jesuit from South America shocked 1 billion Catholics and so many more and stepped out onto the balcony as Pope Francis. And while I wondered on national television what it might be like to be so intensely powerful and famous in a flash, as I stood there dressed in a suit and tie, slathered with pancake makeup, I also couldn't help but think privately back to when I walked those same streets when I was you. T-shirt, shorts, barely able to afford a gelato, in awe of the genius of that same Sistine Chapel. And in that moment, as ever, I remain thankful for my glorious mistake. So here's the deal then. Without the great professors and administrators of Quinnipiac, with their experience and expertise and structure, mistakes are now how all of you will learn. You are going to once again try things and not succeed, and hopefully try them again. To think you worked this hard and came this far, and you're released into a world that sounds a whole lot more like preschool arts and crafts, as it should. Were we ever really happier than with that table piled high of pens and pencils, glue sticks and crayons, colors and textures and possibility, when we could make whatever we wanted and so be whatever we wanted. As we arched and craft, we did so bound only by our imaginations, by our dreams, where mistakes don't exist. They're just new choices to be made. So in closing, know this. The mistakes you make today, you make in the pursuit of those dreams. And I ask then that you love those dreams as much as I once did and still do. I ask that you love those dreams as I now love my daughter. For they, like she, are what you have to live for. And they, like she, are guiding lights and organizing principles, the things you choose never to forsake. That's what I thought about just a few days ago as I finished this speech. And my little four-year-old Serena sat at the same table as Daddy and drew stick figures of herself as a zookeeper and a soccer player and an astronaut. And I thought about how much I loved her and how lucky she was to be able to be three different things in a single afternoon. And so I welcome you to this world, or really, I welcome you back to it. Thank you, and go Bobcats.
Thank you, Josh. It's my privilege to introduce Lee Camlett, Dean of the School of Communications.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the School of Communications faculty, staff, and students, congratulations to all the graduates and to their families. Will the candidates for Bachelor of Arts from the School of Communications please approach the podium? Jeffrey Ross Abrahams, Chelsea Lee Adamchak, Joseph Chapin Adonizio, Stephen Benjamin Aiden, Hannah I. Alagbalea, Stefan Michael Alio, Sally Ann F. Allegretti, Kristen Michelle Ambrosino, Melina Jean Andre, Dane Ann Antonaccio, Anna Marissa Apon, Stephanie Araganello, Michael L. Aletta, Abigail B. Ayub, Jared R. Bayman, Max R. Baldwin, Joshua Barone, Samantha L. Baraka. Samantha is the recipient of the 2013 School of Communications Alumni Association Academic Achievement Award. Samantha graduates with a 3.99 grade point average. She is a communications major from Seymour, Connecticut. She is a member of the Lambda Pi Eta National Communications Honor Society. Samantha plans to pursue a career in television and film production. Joining her on stage are her parents, Deborah and Sal Baraka. Congratulations, Samantha. Matthew John Beckelman, Andrew Philip Bellevo, Matthew H. Bernstein, Jessica Joy Biggs, Ian S. Bliven, Anthony M. Bach, Casey Lorna Bogan, Catherine Elizabeth Boudreau, Ariel Bunas, Alexandria Bovo, Ruby Schubert Browyer, Michelle Annalise Brandau, Daniel M. Brennan, Kira M. Brinkman, Anna Lily Brundage, Rudy Buchanan, Lauren Michelle Bono, Courtney Elizabeth Burnell, Christine J. Baroni, Patrick Ryan Cadigan, Kristen Francis Cagney, Rachel Shelby Cantor, Lisa Nicole Capaccio, Lisa Marie Capobianco, James Robert Capodoro, Michael Alexander Carlson, Molly Rose Carroll, Samantha Casal, Emily Christine Casey, Spencer Christian Cassidy, Sam William Catapano, Anthony M. Centeo, Adam M. Chamish, Stefania Cecilia Charleglio, Kristen Marie Cogashaw, Melissa Colangelo, Cassandra Lynn Como, Ryan Christopher Condi, Megan Elizabeth Conover, Alexandra Marie Condi, Peter G. Corkery, Matthew Thomas Cregan, Megan Lynn Curran, Christopher Francis DeCanto, Nicole Ann DeFranco, Nicole Marie Del Moro, Brianna Maureen Derrimer, Francis J. DeRosa, Laura Nayana Desiral, Jason C. Diaz, Erin Jean Dixon, Cassandra Nicole Demas, Daniel Charles Feely Dolph, Barry Jean Lando Dorman, Eliza Katie Docks, Lauren Michelle Dufour, Kira Louise Duggan, Elizabeth K. Edwards, Kristen Laura Eklund, Barrett William Elliott, Caitlin Carey Enright, Kristen Elizabeth Fite, Elizabeth Bronson Fargo, Morgan Elizabeth Farah, Brian Robert Farrell, Michael Lewis Ferretti, Mark James Fierstein, Jessica Kate Finger, Nicole Alexis Fishman, Christopher Donald Flaherty, Danielle Regina Foley, Chelsea Lee Ford, Bridget Patrice Fossil, John W. Francis, Matthew William Freund, Nicholas Tyler Frias, Thomas James Fresina, Brianne Alyssa Frikas, Cody Freeman Fuller, Anthony Michael Futia, Regina Ann Galuzzo, Victoria Lynn Garcia, Kara Maria Gaskin, Matthias John Gauss, Michelle F. Garrity, Sarah Elizabeth Gentilozzi, Carolyn Lauren Giblin, Jenna Rose Gilberti, Andrew William Gill, Catherine Rose Glidden, Noah Beletsky Golden, Benjamin William Goodhart, Melissa M. Gorman, Spencer David Gutchall, Faith Elizabeth Gumas, Kyle Miller Gravett, Lisa Marie Greshy, Daniel W. Grosso, Megan Carling Guilfoyle, Joanna Jennifer Gutierrez, Alyssa Rose Hackman, Jason Alexandra Hall, Jordan Alexandra Hall. I knew. Mary Caitlin Ellen Harding, Robert Stephen Hendricks, John Robert Hood, Austin Richmond Hopkins, Jacqueline Michelle Izzo, Katarina Diamando Johnson, Simone C. King, Catherine Quinn Colby, Ashley N. Kopacki, Joseph James Kopser, Brianne Alyssa Kovac, Cassandra Marie Crochet, Courtney Francis LaRue, Sophie Laddish, Alana P. Lawrence, Audrey Allison Lawrence, Alex Scott Leifer, Sarah Alma LeDuc, Alexander Michael Linewand, Taylor E. Lepino, Josephine Rosara Liz, Robert Joseph Lobo, Sarah N. Longo, Lee Lopez, Brittany Lee Lyons, Amy M. Mazajowski, Corey C. Mafucci, Alyssa Sharon McGuire, Dennis John Mahoney, Kevin Michael Mahoney, Ryan Isaac Malkey, Sarah Heather Mallett, Ariel Marie Mandel, Sonel Martinez, Samuel Eric Marks, Stephanie Gertrude Matuskowitz, Luke Salvatore Morrow, Kirsten Rita McMahon, Catherine Jan Mendez, Ryan Jeffrey Munir, Alyssa Lindsay Meyer, Tia M. Myers, Taylor Conchetta Massal, Jennifer Marie Migliozzi, Rebecca Lauren Minowalther, Toby M. Momo, Taylor Brianne Monaco, Taylor Margaret Montemurano, Megan Colleen Moore, Michael Matthew Morjazy III, Ryan David Mullett, Sonny H. Nariani, Colleen Elizabeth Nelson, Aaron Victoria Nemeth, Raymond Christian Nesto, Wing Tinoc Foon, Heidi Gardner Nichols, Philip Angelo Nobili, Alyssa Marie Nosti, Kira Marie Opici, Stephanie P. Osmansky, Christina Nicole O'Sullivan, Jesse Alexander Ott, Lauren Krista Otelich, Kirsten Elizabeth Owens, Victor Emmanuel Pagan, Caitlin Hunter Papp, Jillian Michelle Pedrani, Blair Nicole Peterson, Megan Rose Pettarudo, Rachel Ann Piscatelli, Michael Christopher Pitts, Samantha L. Plord, Lauren Ann Polisino, Joshua John Powers, Lauren Nicole Posmanter, Michael James Prado, Lauren G. Provence, Mercy A. Quay, Parisa Marie Ramos, Nicholas David Rando, Jacob Lewis Rifelson, Sarah Brianna Routh, Neil David Ravin, Christopher Cameron Ray, Zoe Jane Redlick, Ethan Ash Rees, Megan Mary Riley, Danielle Catherine Renda, Caitlin Anna Riblett, Samantha Lynn Richards, Kimberly Ann Rizzitano, Stephen Michael Robertson, Augustus Albert Robinson, Erica Marie Rocco, Michael M. Romano, Veronica Alejandra Romo, Zoe Elizabeth Roscoe, Allison May Rossetti, Zachary M. Russo, Callie K. Ryan, Derek Austin Sabetti, Ashley Maria Sade, Alexandra Sanicandro, Stephen Darrell Sawyer, Julie Diane Scanlon, Ryan LaRue Scanlon, Brandon Robert Schindler, John J. Scholl, Dana Marie Schutz, Mark Andrew Schwartz, Courtney Marie Seymour, Blair Whitman Shea, Erica Siciliano, Olivia Page Skitromo, Brian Kevin Slate, Tatiana P. Sosa, Megan Elizabeth Speranzo, Clara Page Spawn, Jill Carol Talbot, Lauren Elizabeth Taylor, Natalie Marie Taylor, Alexandra E. Toombs, Matthew Christopher Torres, Brianna Lynn Vaccaro, Kevin John Vale, Catherine Jane Van Leeuwen, Eric Alexander Ventura, Alexis K. Vieira, Victoria N. Vigilante, Jennifer Dorothy Walker, Stephanie Marie Walls, Leah Karen Wilhelmson, Nancy Christina Zacharakis. President Leahy, it's my honor to present to you the candidates for a Bachelor of Arts degree from the School of Communications.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations to all of you.
It's my privilege to introduce Dr. Edward O'Connor, Dean of the School of Health Sciences.
Will candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science from the School of Health Sciences please approach the podium? Ariana Michelle Aquarulo, Courtney Ann Adams, Aaron Jean Adams, Ryan Joseph Ahern, Abigail Marie Aroldi, Colleen Elizabeth Aiken, Vanessa A. Albornoz, Chloe M. Amber, Emily Ann Amento, Christy Nicole Andrio, Dana Elizabeth Andrews, Elba Miriam Angulo, Courtney Ann Armstrong, Jared M. Arter, Meredith Renee Atkinson, Christina Elizabeth Bacco, Gifty Akua Badu, Kathleen Brittany Balch, Molly Elizabeth Bullier, Stacy Marie Bell, Dana Murray Benick, Megan Maria Santos Biancardi, Kyle S. Bilodeau, Francesca Angela Bongalis, Samantha Ann Bookbinder, Brittany Lynn Bordonero, Catherine Rose Barassa, Carrie Lynn Bradley, Carla Marie Brescia, Alyssa Alexandra Brown, Shannon Michael Brown, Allison Claire Brown, Ashton Brunel, Brianna Ashley Buckley, Jenna Lee Burke, Crystal Lynn Burns, Danielle S. Burns, Sabina Rose Dahl Busby, Chelsea Nicole Bird, Kara Ann Carey, Sungjoon Tori Carlson, Edgar Narciso Carrasco. Matthew Robert Carrera. Emily Merrill, Mary Carroll. Francesca C. Casolino. Jonathan David Casiello. Allison Jenna Serbone. Roseanne Catherine Surrey. Rebecca Lee Chan. Rachel J. Chase. Vivian Seringyi Chow. Samantha Leanne Cromie. Johnson Chu. Carly Flynn Schubert. Tiffany A. Cena. Veronica Michelle Clark. Alyssa M. Clark. Jessica Lee Collins. Adam Javier Colon. Catherine Elizabeth Colucci. Elise Karan Comer. Michaela Ann Connor. Jennifer Lynn Conroy. Stephanie Lynn Coppola. Lindsay Francis Korak. Noelle Christine Corvo. Bianca L. Costa. Brian Patrick Costello. Julianne Helen Couch. Andre Santos Cavacho. Alexandra Mary Cowan. Elizabeth B. Crean. Lauren Jennifer Christopheri. Caitlin Danielle Crooks. Michael M. Cunningham. Samantha C. Cunningham. Mary Alice Kearney. Zachary James Curry. Ariel Simone Kurzman. Joy Rose Delicio. Sean Michael Dembois. Victoria Ann Danner. Miranda Lee Davis. Vincent Frank DeChico. Tara Patricia Dempsey. Andrew William DeSimone. Julianne Desmaris. Michelle Maria D'Souza. Gurdeep Jestra. Joanna Diaz. Heather K. Dimock. Diana Maria DeMuro. Samuel J. Ditkus. Carolyn Michelle Dolan. Megan Elizabeth Donnelly. Ryan Jeffrey Dew. Patrick Duffy. Jocelyn Catherine Delaney. Mason P. Dunn McDonough. Nancy Dunn. Lindsay Renee Duquette. Mary Catherine Durrigan. Kayla M. Dyer. Kirsty Marie Endralunas. Kelsey Garling Eng. Crizel Charmel L. Ursando. Samantha Marie Estella Bate. Ernest Sherwin Usbiao. Benjamin W. Fan. Amy L. Fay. Allison Ann Feeney. Shane Richard Fencer. Lauren Terry Ferrara. Courtney Danielle Ferrara. Justin Andrew Fiore. Jacqueline Diane Flores. Caitlin Rose Foley. Anthony Edward Forlini. Kayleen M. Frank. Marie Elizabeth Fry. Dana Robin Freed. LaDonis L. Golliard. Christina Rose Gallo. Deanna Renee Gable. Melissa Kristen Geis. Brendan Patrick Garrity. Chelsea Marie Ginter. Danielle Stephanie Giordanella. Lorianne Givinello. Lauren Denise Glashine. Jillian Mary Golan. Camilla Gomes. Claudia K. Gonzalez. Amy E. Goss. Carissa Ann Grand. Brittany Lee Gray. Carly Marie Gray. Sarah Ann Gariglia. Gina R. Hahn. Kayla Ann Hamberry. Lindsay Nicole Hamill. Caitlin Patricia Hamerton. Tyler R. Hancock. Melissa Marie Hasty. Caitlin Nancy Hayes. Brianna Lynn Herbert. Richard James Henry. Bennett Michael Holohan. Jill Maxine Humphreys. Patricia Jawar. Ryan Robert John Joseph. Caitlin Louise Johnson. Caitlin Elizabeth Jones. Paula Nicole Jordan. Jonathan Edward Kahane. Natalie Karpinski. Jacqueline Marie Kelleher. Amanda K. Kell. Paula Christine Kennedy. Alexandra Murphy Kidman. Michaela Suzanne King. Brian P. Kissel. Melissa Paige Klein. Philip Anton Kobus. Carolyn Elizabeth Kolb. Michelle C. Cresta. Carrie A. Kuhn. Sarah Elaine Qualwasser. Amanda M. LaFalse. Monica A. Laguna. Ashley Marie LaRiviere. Vanessa Marie LaSala. Danielle Margaret Leahy. Jennifer Helen LeMay. Michael R. Less. Christina L. Liner. Samantha Lauren Lamondo. Jacqueline Lepardo. Kate Elizabeth Lasquadro. Caitlin Margareta Lynch. Megan Ann Lynch. Christopher Matthew Madigan. Robert Michael Mayon. Kelly A. Malloy. Candace M. Mineta. Bianca Hamufar Manguero. Samantha Sonia Markson. Leonardo R. Marquez. Danielle Ann Martin. Matthew Gerard Maciello. Nicole Mastro Batista. Sarah Ashley Matthew. Jacqueline Renee Mathias. Megan Catherine McAllis. Caitlin Elizabeth McCann. Keith L. McCulloch. Kelly Lynn McDonough. Patrick Richard McGinnis. Jennifer Lynn McNaughton. Abita I. Maywash. Melissa M. Mello. Brian R. Masalella. Diana Hope Milano. Courtney Lynn Miller. Christina Jean Mistretta. James Ellie Moore. Cindy M. Moran. Paula P. Morris. Federica Atheline Mucci. Rebecca M. Muller. Catherine Elizabeth Murphy. Kelly Elizabeth Murphy. Elizabeth Michaela Murray. Barbara Lindsay Natalino. Kathleen Elizabeth Nelson. Irina J. Nestor. Alex Robert Neumeister. Jacqueline Rose Navu. Tony Nam Nayuan. Julianne Elizabeth Nugent. Kevin William O'Connell. Erica Teresa O'Leary. Megan Amanda O'Neill. Michael John O'Reilly. Timothy Kirk O'Rourke Jr. Yael S. Ottenstein. Liana Nicole Pagano. Carolyn W. Pelosi. Emily Rose Parker. Jason Jung Chul Park. Catherine Elizabeth Parton. Marta O. Paris. Avani Ashwin Patel. Sweta Gunsham Patel. Lauren Ray Patton. Thomas Brian Patrick. Taylor A. Payne. Christopher S. Pelosi. Timothy William Pellrine. Casey Danielle Perro. Lauren M. Peters. Brad G. Petiti. Pamela Elodie Piard. Daniel Slawek Piaschek. Elizabeth M. Pinzon. Jacqueline R. Plant. Christian Anthony Plunkett. Andrea Elizabeth Plunts. Lauren Elizabeth Poole. Samantha Lauren Pisowski. Eric Rafal Pucka. Jacqueline Quinn. Christopher R. Rago. Kevin P. Raxness. Andrea Francis Rare. Tiffany Camille Reed. Brianna George Reese. John Howard Reisdorf. Emily Ruth Riddlesworth. Alyssa B. Ragazio. Jacqueline Nicole Risto. Sarah Jane Roberts. Kelly Ann Robinson. Andrea Rose Rogers. Christopher Travis Rollo. Larissa Rosenberg. Erica Ashley Rosenthal. Charlotte D. Rosso. Jessica Ann Rossi. Christine Lynn Rotko. Taylor A. Rowe. Bridget Catherine Roy. Alexa Marie Rubino. Christina Marie Rule. Rachel Rusi. Emily Catherine Russo. Catherine J. Sabbath. Allison Marie Santini. Lauren N. Saro. Shannon L. Savisky. Joanna Michelle Scaglione. Jennifer Taylor Scarlett. Frank Vincent Sharippa. Michael Rocco Sharippa. Connor Joseph Schmidt. Allison M. Schneider. Heather Mary Serpa. Nicole L. Serranti. Sonam Tarun Shah. Sonia Navin Shah. Amethyst Lynn Shepherd. Megan Christine Siever. Danielle Beth Silverstein. Vinod Vinny Singh. Lindsay Rhiannon Smith. Pamela Ann Smith. Rebecca E. Smith. Shaisa Andrea Smith. Zachary David Smith. Jessica Rachel Sola. Chloe Suzanne Sondler. Joseph Pellegrino Sorrentino. Kaylin A. Spann. Kevin Anthony Spano. Ryan Stanley Spencer. Megan Elizabeth Sprague. Lindsay E. Soror. Aaron Amanda Staples. Siobhan Noel Stellato. Samantha Rachel Stern. Jillian Lee Strassner. Jennifer Rose Strauss. Kara Alexandra Succi. Catherine Ann Sullivan. Colleen Michelle Sutherland. Aaron Suvar. Aaron Sweeney. Jillian Laura Texeri. Emily Catherine Taylor. Valerie Nicole Thompson. Leanne M. Toomey. Ken Tien Tran. Nicole I. Trepper. Isabella Maria Tricolo. Andrea Sigakos. Arthur William Tyler. Jill Catherine Underwood. Laura Ellen Velikas. Janelle Christine Van Luling. Georgia Alexandra Vasilakos. Felicia Lee Viweg. Nicole Alexa Vituli. Nicholas M. Verderis. Amber L. Wachtars. Keelan Elizabeth Walsh. Lauren Elizabeth Walsh. Amanda Lee Walters. Catherine Marie Wiedekin. Christine Joy Way. Jamie Michelle Weisberg. Caitlin Ann Welch. Maggie Elizabeth Welch. Alyssa Marie Welch. Lauren Marie Wendell. Rebecca Lynn Werner. Cooper L. Westerkamp. Rebecca Ori White. Morgan Ann Whittle. Aaron Brianna Williams. Jillian M. Williams. Megan E. Williams. Megan is the recipient of the 2013 School of Health Sciences Alumni Association Academic Achievement Award. Megan graduates today with a 3.97 GPA and is an athletic training and sports medicine major from Auburn, Massachusetts. She is a member of the Alpha Eta National Honor Society. Megan has accepted a position as the head athletic trainer at Guilford High School. Joining her on stage are her parents, Sue and Scott Williams. Congratulations, Megan. Amy Julia Winarda. Amanda Grace Wolfenden. Ryan Kenneth Wolf. Hannah J. Wood. Megan Constance Woodruff. Stephanie Lynn Woods. Keith R. Yatoro. Christine Ann Young. Elise Erica Zaffos. Joanna Zagrita. Nicole Ashley Zabrowski. Arielle Lynn Ziering. Daniel James Zinkus. Mr. President, it is my honor to present to you candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science from the School of Health Sciences.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Science with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations to all of you.
On behalf of the faculty and staff of the School of Health Sciences, congratulations to all of today's graduates.
It's my privilege to introduce Dr. Jean Lang, Dean of the School of Nursing.
Would the candidates for a Bachelor of Science in Nursing please approach the podium? How's that? Yes. Alexandra Christine Alexiadis. Ashley Ann Antonucci. Emma Claire Ehrenholz. Stephanie Lynn Berry. Colby Pragati Bennett. Catherine Elise Blakesley. Aislinn Marie Bach. Kimberly Marie Bolognese. Thomas Anthony Booth. Sarah Elizabeth Borders. Rianne Christine Brickley. Liza Ann Broccoli. Nicole Catherine Brown. Erin Eleanor Burke. Julia Elizabeth Burkhart. Michelle Elaine Burns. Jessica Paige Cabral. Alyssa Marie Cagliano. Sarah Victoria Callahan. Thomas Nicholas Chaber. Claire Maxine Charette. Madeline Serena Cepiini. James Andrew Chaburi. Aubrey Ann Clements. Danielle Marie Cote. Jenna Irene Cox. Brittany Ann Critella. Samantha Lynn Crisciolo. Nicole Marie Dalio. Julia Adele Dalton. Paige Stephanie Damley. Sarah Andriana DeFino. Catherine Helen DeGrazia. Melinda E. DeLucia. Alyssa B. DeVeser. Kristen N. DeLeo. Melissa E. DeMond. Lorraine Jennifer DeSa. Irene Ajanri. Kara Lynn Ellis. Leonella Espinal. Ariel Fishbane. Jillian Lee Fishbine. Catherine Amy Fishman. Carrie Danielle Fitzgerald. Ian Gregory Forbes. Jenna Ashley Forte. Lauren Ann Fasci. Chelsea Ann Frizzone. Kelly Ann Gallagher. Allison Mary Gendron. Let's see here. Nicholas J. DiGerminario. Alyssa M. Gertanano. That is the right. Catherine Ann Glass. Monica D. Green. Allison Paige Hamill. Megan Ashley Hahnemann. Taylor Jane Healy. Brittany Lauren Hill. Justin Kent Hillmeyer. Jonathan H. Hoisel. Avery Ann Holman. Jennifer L. Hopley. Chelsea M. Hutton. Tracy Ann Jandreau. Tracy Ann Andronette Johnson. Abigail Carol Key. Right. Andrea L. Klepacki. Kristen Renee Coach. Amanda Ashley Kranz. Michelle Elena Lachetti. Michelle Elizabeth Lafferty. Kaylee Elizabeth Lavin. Patricia A. Libid. Catherine Crandall Lottridge. Brandon Keith Lynn. Christina Marie Lyons. Linda Sylvia Magliocco. Kimberly Marie Mansfield. Sarah Elizabeth McGrath. Nicole Elizabeth McKenzie. Danielle Marie Mendola. Olivia B. Miko. Samantha Christine Neville. Kelsey Ann Norton. Michael Joseph O'Brien. Alba Victoria Ortega. Rachel Nicole Ouellette. Roseanne Petanito. Lindsay Elizabeth Petrovich. Angela Marie Pollies. Megan Christine Prestridge. Casey Claire Quinlan. Kaylee Elizabeth Ritchie. Alexa Joyce Rizzardi. Monica M. Rogan. Chelsea Elizabeth Ryan. Rachel Ashley Sarnovich. Mary Catherine Sharp. Melissa A. Schwartz. Jake Aaron Sebastian. Anna Elizabeth Sheehan. Nancy Jean Scucciamari. Kate Louise Stammel. Sarah Elizabeth Studley. Caitlin Reamer Sullivan. Andrea M. Charkowitz. Tiffany Ann Texera. Gina M. Travado. Gina is the recipient of the 2013 School of Nursing Alumni Association Academic Achievement Award. Gina graduates with a 3.97 GPA. Gina is a nursing major from Mahopac, New York. She's a member of the Sigma Theta Tau International Nursing Honor Society and plans to pursue her master's degree upon graduation. Joining her on stage are her parents, Marie and Charlie Travado. Congratulations, Gina. Chelsea Patricia True. Melissa Elsa Turnblom. Jackson Christopher Viscuso. Emily Wright Vincent. Elena Michelle Veronin. Catherine Ann Walsh. Mr. President, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for Bachelor of Science in Nursing.
Oh, we need them. By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Science with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations to all of you.
On behalf of the School of Nursing, we congratulate all of today's graduates.
It's my privilege to introduce Timothy O'Rourke, a biomedical sciences major from Wappingers Falls, New York, to give the response to the class of 2013.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson, and members of the platform party. My fellow friends, peers, colleagues, esteemed faculty and staff, it is a distinct honor to stand before you today. This is a day that we will most certainly remember for the rest of our lives as the culmination of our years as undergraduates at Quinnipiac University. For many of us, QU has become a home away from home, a place where we came comfortable in being ourselves, exploring our similarities and differences while working towards a common goal. This common goal has become a reality. Here we are graduating from this distinguished university. Our family and friends are surely proud of the things that we have accomplished and the places that we will go. But at this time, you should all pat yourselves on the back in recognition of a job well done. When I think of a way to summarize our years as undergraduates, one word immediately comes to mind: construction. It has surrounded us on the Mount Carmel campus, at York Hill, and in North Haven. It has connected us in Hamden and the greater New Haven area. It has pervaded the entirety of our educational experience here at QU. But construction, it seems, can be interpreted in more than one way. Yes, we've had forklifts and bulldozers. It seemed that the giant blue fence surrounding the student center had become a permanent structure of the quad. Think about the word construction. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines construction as the active process of building something. Taken literally, yes, there seem to be constant renovations and building in order to accommodate the tremendous growth of our university. Taken in a more abstract way, however, I think the word construction summarizes our experiences as Quinnipiac undergraduates in a much more profound way. We have been building ourselves as individuals throughout our education, through studying, researching, writing, participating in class, interacting with our peers, interacting with our administrators, working with our mentors, meeting with our advisors, taking the time to think about where we see ourselves in the future. We are constantly in the process of building something. And, as it seems, this construction will never end. Look around you. I mean that literally, too. The future is upon us. All that we have been working towards in our undergraduate careers has seemingly come full circle. As we close this chapter of our lives, it is important to reflect and consider our experiences in the last years. Also, take the time to show your appreciation to those who made these experiences possible. I think it is safe to say that we have experienced growth in many facets as individuals. The relationships that we have developed and the people we have met will be dear to us for the rest of our lives. When we commenced our undergraduate studies as freshmen, I'm sure each and every one of us heard the same thing: enjoy your time in college, because it will be over before you know it. I'm sure I'm not alone in feeling that this statement could not have been more accurate. Opportunity now lies ahead of each and every one of us. Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "Do not follow where the path may lead. Go, instead, where there is no path, and leave a trail." With a Quinnipiac University education, the opportunities before us are endless. We have equipped ourselves with the tools to achieve successful and fruitful lives. We must now go forth and continue to live our core values as individuals, always pushing to be the best that we can be. No matter the industry, education, or line of work that may lie ahead, we need to challenge ourselves day in and day out to live up to our full potential as individuals. We will continue to be challenged in the future, but we must work hard to persevere and keep our sights set on the goal at hand. Today, we graduate from Quinnipiac University. To some, this may seem like the end, but I assure you, this is merely the beginning. Our teachers and mentors have prepared us for this day. Each and every night spent in the library studying for that midterm, writing that paper, and experiencing countless hours of class time all culminates today with the receiving of our undergraduate degrees. Within the next weeks, we will diverge in countless directions to pursue our respective futures, working towards attaining the goals that we have set for ourselves in this vast world. Unfortunately, I believe that all of us will never be together in one place at the same time again. We will be eternally connected, however, that we will always be the one and only Quinnipiac University Class of 2013. Congratulations to all, and best wishes in all of your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, Timothy. Congratulations to all. Would you please stand? Please remain standing after the benediction until the platform party and all graduates have recessed. Following that, you're invited to join us in greeting the new graduates at a reception under the tents. School of Health Sciences to the right as you walk out. School of Nursing, School of Communications, to the left. It's now my privilege to ask Reverend Hugh Vincent Dyer, Director of Campus Ministry and Catholic Chaplain, to give the benediction.
Peace be with you. Almighty God, we ask you to pour down your blessings upon these graduates, as abundant and generous as you have sent rain today. May they go forth with mind and heart renewed. May they grow consistently in the perseverance of virtues, of virtues that accord to human excellence, of knowing and loving and of serving those in need. May they always be generous, grateful, and loving, and work with eager hands to serve with integrity those whom they will encounter, those families they will raise, in all the ways and places you call them to. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.